Okay, you will notice looking down at this outlet, see how it's bowed out, like it's forced into the box. There were way too many wires forced into this box. I'll take the open the box up so you can see how crowded it up it was. Make sure the power is off, which it is. Okay, we have some broken strands here and a couple sloppy connections here. Now they remarked this white wire as a ground with a green tape, so that's okay to do. So I'm gonna bring the camera down close and show you the sloppy connections that I found here. Okay, on that white wire, see the broken strands and see the sloppy connection on the green screw? So first we'll fix our ground wire here. We left a lot of ground wire on here, so we'll take it off of here. It'll be just easier to cut it and get rid of it. There. And it's all wrapped up around this white wire. Which makes it harder to fuss and fight with. Okay, now we got them all out here. And we can take this apart. Let's see what they did there. It's not quite even here, so I'll take put that on even. I'll twist these wires together so they're tight and they're pretty even here. So I'll just put the red wire right in here because we don't need that big gray one, because you can put four number 12s. In a red wire knot. sloppily, we'll take it off. And since this is a pressure plate type of connection, we'll take it out of here altogether. We'll straighten it up. And we'll clip it just a little bit shorter. And we'll put it in the back here. Make sure it goes in far enough. We'll clip that back a little bit more. Broken strands on the white wire here. I'll take that one out and redo it. Oops, maybe they're not broken. They're just, somebody just shoved them in without twisting them together. So I'll just twist them together here nicely. I'll just take a little smidgen off. Pull off the insulation here. I'll twist them a little bit tighter. And we'll get down in the hole here. Make sure all the strands get down into the hole. What the last person did is they just shoved them in and frayed them all out. There, now they're down in. These are down in all the way. Now make sure it's nice and tight. No, I'll come around here and get this one again. And I'll check the black sides, yeah, they did over here. Okay, they have a stranded and a solid in the same hole. So I'm going to take the put the two stranded ones in the same and the solid one in a separate hole because the stranded ones are mushier and it may loosen up in the black one. That's okay, so I'm going to push that black one in, make sure it's in all the way. Okay, where's the other one here? There's this one. Okay, I'm going to get these strands twisted down and nice and tight. I'm going to loosen this up all the way here. Messing up the strands. Why isn't that going in? I really hate forcing stuff. But if something's not going to go, it's not going to go. Maybe I'll open this one up and put this black one up here, solid one up here. Maybe I'll have better luck using it, just using a different hole. Okay, it's here. They're the same, but you know what? I'm not gonna fuss. I'm gonna just wire them together and hook it up. That's all there is to it. I'm not gonna play games. I'm gonna get it done and done right. I bring in a fresh strip, see if that will go in. Yes, it will. So I'll do it that way then. So strip twisting them kind of balled them up a lot. So there we go, we got one. Okay, so I'm going to have to shorten this one up just a little bit. Okay, now we're getting them in the way I like them, just like that. Okay, beer copper, I'm going to bring that, I'm going to just trim these off a slight bit more, so that, just very slightly, I don't want too much copper showing behind it. Like, I want to get the insulation right up to the bottom of the pressure plate terminal here, like that. Now we'll strip this one. This is number 12 on a 20 amp breaker, so we're using number 12. One, two. Okay, I'm just going to make sure my wires all stayed in. Now I'm going to flip this around. Now I'll get this ground wire up there on the green screw. I'm gonna get this wire nut in the back here so it's out of the way of everything. Okay, now we got our connection the way I want it here. Now I brought a much deeper box here. And you can see the depth difference, so that there is more room for the wire, so nothing is pinched. So we'll break our little tabs out for the wire mold. One. Two. Three. Alrighty, now we can get this in here. This. Okay, it's in the way I want it. hold it in with this finger here. Make sure it's tight. Okay, now we can put this on. This is the box. Being able to bend down and see just makes this a little harder. I just can't see. Having the light helps a lot. My light back down here. So it's very important not to have too many wires in your box and too many wire nuts, because if you force your device into the box, you can end up pinching a wire and causing a short. Peace. Thanks for watching.